welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week, the Hampden Academy Broncos and the Brewer Witches. That was the Hampden Academy Band, led by Band Director Ben Aldridge. And there's quite a crowd gathering here at Hampden Academy. Take a quick look at the stats here. First for Brewer, the visiting team. It's Ricky Adams, 1-for-4 for 15 yards. Rushing-wise, it's Burnham, 5 carries, 19 yards. Meeker, 2 carries, 11 yards. Adams, 2 carries for 7 yards. Tim Bush, 2 carries for 4 yards. And it's Kobe Hutchins with a rush for 16 yards receiving. Ryan Babin, 1 catch for 15 yards. For the Hampden Academy Broncos, Sean Smith, 1-for-3, 6 yards, but 2 interceptions. Kyle Ross, 21 carries, 123 yards, and a touchdown. So he's having a great game. Bob Seeger, 9 rushes, 46 yards. Sean Smith, 4 rushes for 11 yards. Number 5, Craig Sarnecki, he has a rush for 5 yards. And Justin Kelsey has a rush for 4 yards. Bob Seeger, 1 catch, 6 yards for Hampden Academy. But the big difference, that Kyle Ross touchdown, and what a game Mr. Ross has put together for himself today.
Well, anytime you rush, what, 143 yards here, I mean, that's usually a stat that you would have at the end of the game. I mean, he is having a phenomenal game, doing nothing but just misdirection plays, trying to freeze Brewer's linebackers a little bit, and their defensive ends having a little bit of a guessing game that's going on right now, and Hampden's definitely winning that.
So Kyle Ross, number 43, the senior, nickname is Ross Dog. He's played football for 6 years. He's playing fullback, halfback, and linebacker. Plays some basketball, baseball, as well as soccer. Obviously, he's not playing for soccer for the school this year. He enjoys lifting weights. He's going to college for optometry, which is something very rare. This is the big part right here. He's going exactly how his favorite athlete, Jerome Bettis, the bus. You can see the same type of ground
really?
Game there.
He is.
Bettis, one of those players that were one of the ones that wanted to always run over players, and here you see Ross, he's running players over, and
yeah,
no sign
of he's determined. We've seen a couple plays where he could have been wrapped up in a line of scrimmage, and he's just squaring the shoulders and he's driving the legs. He is very determined. He's a very determined young man to get the extra yards and to get this win for Hampden tonight.
And the captains are meeting. It's going to be Brewer receiving the kick this time. So we're going to take a break. When we come back, it'll be the third quarter. The Brewer Witches, the Hampden Academy Broncos, homecoming weekend for Hampden. Hampden on top, 7-0. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week.
At this time, we'd like to pause for a moment of silence before we begin the second half for a man that has put this whole video production together. His name is Mr. Bill Baxter. He was the co-founder of My Video Productions, very involved in the youth growing up, and our condolences are with Eric and Pam Baxter, who are the producers of this, and their family. So if we could please pause now for a moment of silence for Mr. Bill Baxter.
Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week, the Hampden Academy Broncos and the Brewer Witches. As you see, Brewer receiving the kick here.
Well, Kobe Hutchins on a great job that time, taking the ball on the 15-yard line and moving it up to the 36-yard line now. Great return of 26 yards. Brewer with pretty good field position here to start the second half.
So Rick Adams will bring on the Hampden, the Brewer Witches, excuse me, on offense here for Brewer. And we'll see if Brewer can get some points on the board. Trailing 7-0 here in the third quarter.
They're not doing a good, they are doing a great job of just ball controlling. They just need to get a few more yards per carry right now.
So Brewer coming to the line now. And there's going to be the handoff. Can't really see who that one was to, but
it's like Timmy Bush right up the middle that time.
And Bush getting up to about the 40. Looks like a gain of 3 yards on the play.
Great job that time by Hamden's linebackers coming up, making a stop that time. First guy that got him was number 40. That's Michael Judkins, a sophomore for Hampden, in on the play.
Now Adams back under center again, scanning the defense. He's going to hand it off to number 26 of Brewer. And I believe this might be the first time we've seen number 26 in there for Brewer.
No, and that's number 26. That's Cameron Jamison. And he looks like he's going to be real close to picking up the first down. I don't have what age Mr. Judkins is in, but I believe he may be a freshman.
He is a freshman. He's the only freshman on this Hampden Academy team, 6 feet, 202 pounds, so a big freshman.
And they had a very successful junior high program. We always talk about, you can see when success breeds success, their junior high team went undefeated last year here in Hampden.
And now Brewer looking at a first and 10 on the 47. Handoff to Hutchins. He's going to cross the 50, the 45, 40. He's got good speed, good open field speed there. Brought down around the 39, but that was a great burst of speed that you need to see. And
well, that's what they were looking for. They were doing a great job, as I said, of getting 2 or 3 yards of pickup, but they needed someone to step up, bring those big plays, and Hutchins just ran off 13 or 14 yards, and more importantly was the execution, cutting across the green that time and keeping his head up, running with the football.
Great carry there by Hutchins, and you haven't seen that burst of speed from Brewer until that play right there, so he could be something for Brewer to have.
Wonder if he got that from his father, Randy. Randy was a great football player down at Lawrence High School.
And Brewer's going to hand it off this time to number 36. And that's going to be Doug Nunn. So
different bunch of group of players getting in here now for the Witches, running the football here in the second half.
And I think Brewer's trying to just throw people in there, trying to see who can do it.
Well, he's probably trying to say who's going to step it up. Maybe he challenged these guys at halftime.
And Tim Bush coming in now for Brewer. So Brewer throwing multiple looks here at Hampden Academy. And looking at a second and 10 from the 39 now. Adams going to give it to Bush. Bush, nice tackle there by number 53, Matt York, the senior, 6'1", 221 pounds from Hampden Academy. Great open field tackle.
Well, Matt York did nothing. Just coming from his defensive tackle position, stunted right across, untouched. Met him in the backfield for a loss, bringing up a third and 10 now for Brewer.
Now Doug Naughton coming back into the game for Brewer. So Brewer putting a new running back in almost on every play here. Hutchins back in there as well for Brewer.
And you got to figure this may be a two-down series here for the Witches.
Third and 10, the handoff to Hutchins. He breaks another tackle up to the 30, brought down around the 29. So there's that speed factor again. He's going to be close to a first down.
Did a great job of, once again, going to the outside. That's where the play was designed, but it was kind of sealed. He did a great job cutting across the grain. Picking up the extra yards, going to bring up about a fourth and 2 now for Brewer.
Fourth down, and Brewer looking at some short yardage here. Be very interesting to see what they do. Could be Adams with a little sneak, or it could be a handoff to Bush. It is going to be the handoff to Bush. He's got a first down and more. Out to about the 17-yard line, maybe down around the 16. A good carry there by Tim Bush.
Yeah, a saving tackle that time by Bobby Seeger. He comes up from a safety position, but Bush was determined. He carried Mr. Seeger for 3 or 4 yards.
And Bush coming off to the sidelines now. Be interesting to see what Brewer does here.
Maybe their philosophy in the second half was when they rotate the backs and keeping them fresh, maybe they want to keep Hampden's defense out there and just keep wearing them down.
Naughton in there at fullback, Hutchins in the backfield. So Bush is out again, and it's going to be Adams with the keeper. keeps it himself inside the 10, brought down around the 9 or 8 yard line. A good carry there by Rick Adams.
Brought down by Mike Butler for Hampden.
I'm going to bring him down around the 10, I guess. 7 yard gain for Adams, and Naughton coming out, and here comes Bush. So I think this is working here. They one play, they're swapping them out,
they're
bringing in that freshest back.
Right now they're using three or four backs in there. They're mixing everybody up, keeping everybody fresh. And they've gone on some steam drive. This started back at the 36-yard line.
Let's see what Brewer does this time. I'm saying probably hand off to Bush.
In the power eye formation.
No, hand off to Hutchinson. And he's going to lose some yardage there as Hampden's defense picked it up and was there early.
They wanted to go to the outside. There was a little bit of Adams coming back, handing to Hutchinson. Didn't quite get the ball in and into his gut where he wanted to, and then that held Kobe up for a couple seconds. And anytime you hold one of the running backs up for a couple seconds, that gives the defensive line to do a great job of shooting the gaps and getting in there.
Craig Starnecki in there on the tackle, number 5 for Hampden Academy.
Bring up a 3rd and 9 with the ball on the 16. 7 minutes to go here in the third quarter.
And Adams coming to the line to scan the defense. The handoff to Naughton. Naughton going to get hit and dropped.
Did a great job of opening the hole up that time, but the freshman there, Judkins for Hampden, did a nice job of coming up and filling the hole. Anytime you're a freshman, you're a 200-pounder. I'm sure the coach was pretty ecstatic to get him up here.
We want to thank some more of our sponsors. Page Employment, matching people to jobs since 1945. Need a job? No fees. Need employees? Call Page 991-9615. Seaboard Security, providing uniform security officers to Maine companies since 1988. Security you can trust. And it looks like Tim Bush is going to attempt the field goal. Adams the holder. We could see a fake here. The kick is up, and the kick is good.
That was Dylan Fitzpatrick.
Excuse me, Fitzpatrick. That's right. Fitzpatrick does the kicking. So Brewer cuts it. A 4-point lead now. 7-3 with 6:10 to go here in the third quarter. We're going to take a break. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week.
When you have an important point to make, don't clutter up the ad with all sorts of extra information. If Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee, then we should just say that. Page Employment doesn't charge workers a fee. No fee. There, we said it. Jim's Small Engines on Snow's Corner Road in Orrington has what you need when it comes to tackling yard work. Whether you're looking for expert service and repair from guys with more years of experience than they may care to admit, or if you're in the market for a new mower, snowblower, string trimmer, generator, or pressure washer, Jim's Small Engines on Snow's Corner Road in Orrington is the right place to go. Call Jim's Small Engines at 825-3527 or visit them on the web at jimsmallengines.com.
Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week. Brewer on the board with a field goal, a 28-yard field goal, and he had the distance to probably put that in from about 35, if not even further, by Dylan Fitzpatrick. And the kick's going to take a good bounce there. Fielded at the 20 by number 7 of Hampden Academy. That's Justin Kelsey. He gets it up to about the 25. Now, Kelsey's a tight end on this team.
Brought down by number 7. So 7 and 7 collide that time. Tristan Olmixer on the tackle.
And now, Brewer's defense looking to have to step up big here. I also want to thank Quality Jewelers with new location at the Penobscot Plaza in Bangor for fine jewelry. Carefree Windows and Siding for your siding and window and roofing needs. Everyone at Carefree wishes you a successful football season. Bangor Optical, Mount Hope Avenue in Bangor, and check out their new office, the Eye Center Optical, located in the Weber Building by EMMC in Bangor.
Well, you speak of Devin Fitzpatrick there. Not only is he a very good football player, he's one of the instrumental guys on the hockey team that helped lead them into the Class B states last year.
And Hampden Academy, their first offensive possession here in the second half, and they're going to go right back to what worked earlier, the handoff to Ross.
Just a simple straight dive, right off tackle. Straight right on man-to-man blocking. They're going to see if they can just push the witches back, and they did.
And if you're Brewer and Coach Farnham, you want this defense to get a stop. You want to get that Hampden defense back out there because you ran them. And you got him tired.
Yeah, and what we saw is Coach Farnham was talking to the four backs, and he was hunting. Every time we go to a certain play that I'm going to call. He says, I want you guys rotating in and out all the time.
And it's going to be a handoff to Ross along the near side. A great job there. Number 8 for Brewer. And that's Jared Davis. He was there, and he slowed down the run of Ross. And once he slowed him down, the rest of the Brewer defenders were there and all ready to help bring him down.
Great job by the defensive backs that time for the Witches as Adams and Davis that time came up and made a great defensive stance that time. They're going to force a third and long three now for the Broncos.
So now Brewer, the defense picking it up big here as their team starting to get into it now on the sidelines.
And you can hear Coach Farnham. He's hauling and clopping. He's trying to get these guys fired up.
Smith hands off to Ross. And Ross is going to be...
I believe this good second effort of plunging down, keeping the knees going, is going to, and the legs drive, is going to give him the first down, and it does.
And he dragged a defender there. Jared Davis had him wrapped up around the waist, but the legs kept turning there for Ross.
Yeah, so square the shoulders, just keep on driving, and that's what he did for an extra 3 yards, and he gave the Broncos a first down in Brewer's territory.
And now Smith... coming back up to the line here. He's got Seeger in the backfield. Smith is going to keep it himself. He's going to scramble along the far side, across the 50, up to about the 47 for being brought down there.
Brought down by number 7, once again, Tristan Olmexer. Brewer did a great job, even though they was going to run wide, they did a great job of spacing everything out and keeping the play going to the outside. They did not let them run north to south. They made them run east to west. Anytime a defense can stretch them out and do that, it's a great job.
And now Brewer. The defense here going to have to come up big. Second and 8 on the 47. 7-3 your score in favor of Hampden Academy. Smith hands it off to Ross. Ross crosses the 45, still turning those legs. Brought down at the 41, so a good carry there again by Kyle Ross.
Once again, Doug Naughton hit him right on the waist where he's supposed to and draw it down, but you've got to really wrap up against him because he's going to drag you for a good 2 or 3 yards every play. So they're going to have to really lay the shoulder pads into him and then drop down and wrap the legs up and put him down. If not, he's just going to drag him on.
We want to thank Jim Small Engines for mowers to snowblowers and all your yard equipment needs. Snow's Corner Road in Orrington, sales and expert service. Smith, he's going to lunge forward. And he might be a yard short here for first down. Not too often you see a quarterback sneak on third down, but.
Anthony Noll on the tackle that time for Brewer.
And we'll see what they do here. And they're going to measure it. And you also want to thank Bangor Canvas, covering all your canvas needs. The corner store where Gabby Price wishes everyone the best of luck. Northeastern Log Homes for quality log homes. And Edge Video, they have the edge on your video needs. With a larger selection of new releases and hard-to-find videos, locations in the Brewer Shopping Center and on State Street in downtown Bangor. It's going to be a first down for Hampden Academy. And also, high-quality DVDs of this game will be available. Call Eric Baxter at 991-9615. You are watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week, the Hampden Academy Broncos, the Brewer Witches. Adam Mahaney alongside Tim Kenney. And the pitch there is going to be to Seeger. Seeger along the far side. He's going to be brought down around the 44.
Well, once again, we talked about not letting Hampden run, you know, north to south. Let him run east to west, and that's what they did again. They stretched the play out that time. Brewer's number 8, Jared Davis, stretching the play out along with Timmy Bush and bringing him down, this time for a loss of 4 yards.
And also Tom Corbett. All right, excellent statistician today, giving us all the stats, keeping us up to date.
Yeah, thanks, Tony, keeping us in line here tonight. We really appreciate it. Extra set of hands definitely helps out in any situation, especially like this.
Handoff. It's going to be to Ross. And really, when you get into a situation like that where you've got 3 players pushing one way and 4 pushing the other way, come to a standstill.
Kind of like a tug of war here, but Brewer's doing a good job of gang tackling, and that's what they've got to do, especially against a big, rugged senior like Ross. I mean, he's not going to come down on the first hit. These kids know that Brewer's going to win this football game and weigh him down. They're going to have to make contact, great form tackling, and then drop and wrap the arms around the knees to bring him down.
Yeah, look at it this way. Brewer had the ball to start this quarter. They had it for 6 minutes and put up 3 points. Hampden's well on pace to have the ball for 6 minutes, and we'll see what they do. Smith is going to give it to Ross again. Ross has got a first down and more, the 20, the 10, 5, and he's taking it in for a touchdown for Hampden Academy.
Great play that time by Ross. He went right through the line, squared those shoulders, and you could just hear him popping shoulder pads all the way through. Got into the secondary, popped a couple more guys, and then he was off to the races for the last 18 yards, and he puts another six in the house for the Broncos.
So a great, great run there for Kyle Ross, who's having a phenomenal game today. Unbelievable performance by the senior. His last homecoming game, it was a must-win for Hampden Academy, and just look what he's done today.
Well, there's no question about it. I mean, he's with 143 yards, and Tom's adding them up right here as we go through, but I mean, he is, there's no question in my mind, he'll definitely be in consideration for Player of the Week in the LTC as we get a false start here on Hampden. 183 yards so far here in the game with a minute 22 to go in the third quarter.
He's, like you said, definitely player of the game consideration. I mean, he's had a phenomenal game.
Yeah, player, definitely consideration player of the game, but also he'll be in consideration, I would definitely say, for Player of the Week in the LTC. He's a great job tonight. You can't ask more from a kid like that. That's what senior leadership will bring to you, especially looking as they know they need this win to get into the playoffs. Both teams will probably go on the road, but it doesn't matter. When you make the playoffs, it's a whole new season.
And the kick is up, and the kick is good. So the penalty helped him. They missed the first kick, and this one he puts through. So 1:22 to go. It's 14-3 in favor of Hampden Academy. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll have more. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week. Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week. The Hampden Academy Broncos, the Brewer Witches, 14-3 your score in favor of Hampden Academy in a must-win game for Hampden. Homecoming weekend, the emotions are high for them, and they're playing well today. And that kick's going to go out of bounds, and we'll see where Brewer wants to take it. This is the second time this has happened.
Well, there's three scenarios you can, well, actually two that you really give them is you take the, add this three. Let me go back and let everybody know. When you kick the ball out of bounds, if the ball goes past the 35-yard line, then there's only two situations. You can have them re-kick with a 5-yard penalty or take the ball at the 35. The only other scenario would be if the ball went out up beyond the 35, then they, of course, would have the scenario of taking the ball where it went out and re-kick, and it looks like they're going to make them re-kick.
Always good to have the official up here in the booth. Well, the rules.
I've had some good teachers over the years, especially with Ralph Dameron, who's a state interpreter that does our classes every Tuesday night, and Neil Waterman and Bruce Anderson and Andy Constantine. There's been a bunch of them, so I probably should thank them because they've helped me along the way, and I really appreciated those senior veterans on our refereeing crew.
And Brewer took the penalty. They want Hampden to re-kick here. And back deep for Brewers, number 22, Delray Meeker, number 27, Bob Coombs, and number 10, Kobe Hutchins. And that kick's going to go, and it's going to be fielded by Hutchins at the 20. Crosses across the 30.
Got a seam.
35-40.
Loose football.
Loose football. And the officials are going to say he was down.
Down by contact, and the ball, when the ball hits the ground, the ball cannot cause a fumble.
Great heads-up play, though, by Jared Davis of Brewer. He saw the fumble, and he still went down on it just in case, and he came away with it. So,
well, Brewer's in great field position right here on the 43-yard line.
And we'll see what Rick Adams can do here for Brewer.
Well, now's the time the offensive line's got to step up. They've got to knock those holes open for Hutchins and Meeker and Bush to get in there. They've got to start getting 4, 5, 6 yards at a pop here.
If you're Brewer, you want to hurry up and try to score here. And it's Bush across the 50, the 45, and brought down at the 42-yard line.
Great move by Timmy Bush that time, went right up the middle.
There's some yellow on the field, and it's not the lines, it is some flags. There's a couple flags thrown on the field. One was thrown a little bit later.
Get a
face mask.
Let's see if it's an intentional or unintentional. I couldn't see what Mr. Heath was saying. Personal foul, grabbing the face mask. We don't know if it's a 5 or 15. And he's going to mark off 15. So that's a big rap. That's a big penalty against Hampden. No, it was not an unintentional, but you got to give Bush credit. I mean, he busted through the line. That's when you could see he wanted that one. And he cut to the outside, made a great stutter step move, cut back to the inside. And then when he was tackled, the helmet was grasped for 15 yards, which was tacked on to the end of the run, putting Brewer inside the 30-yard line now.
And just like their last drive, Bush out, nodding in. And Adams is going to keep it himself along the near side. He's going to get it up to about the 24-yard line. A gain of 3. Clock is still ticking here.
Met that time by number 53, Noah Johnson. Excuse me, Matt, you up? Looks like Adams wanted to freeze the defensive end that time, but the defensive end did a good job of stepping in and sealing him, forcing the play back inside. Adams didn't have nowhere to pitch the ball to the outside, so he had to tuck it in and run it up the middle.
Great night for football, clear skies.
But we have seen our breath for the first time tonight.
And the handoff is going to be to Bush. He gets it up to about the 18, so 5-yard gain there.
And he's tackled at time by number 50, Tyler
Furrow. And that's going to do it for the third quarter. We're going to head to the fourth. Brewer trailing 14-3 to Hampden Academy. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week.
During our lifetime, priorities change, and we begin to seek out products that enhance our lives. We move and we grow and come to realize what's truly important. We begin to understand the value of our time and see the results of investing wisely. Priorities change, standards don't. Paradigm Windows of Portland, Maine. Windows solutions for life.
Available from Carefree Window and Siding Company. Call 989-4260.
Northeastern Log Home's four-star promise, to design the dream home that's perfect for you and your family. To ensure your home will be built with materials of the highest quality and durability and offered at a fair price. To deliver a complete easy build package with more of what you need, like Anderson Windows, Owens Corning Shingles, and Morgan Doors. To provide factory direct expert assistance every step of the way for as long as you own your home.
Come visit us in Kandeskeg and we'll help build your dreams with our experience.
Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week. The Brewer Witches have traveled here to Hampden for their homecoming game, and Hampden Academy on top 14-3 in the fourth quarter. Hand off to Bush. Bush is going to muscle his way forward.
Looks like it's close. He can't see because of an angle. Looks like he may have gotten the first down that time and put the ball close to the 20-yard line, and he did get the first down. Well, that's a senior right there stepping it up. He's carried the ball the last two times for probably, 20 yards?
You know, at this point in high school football, with 11:50 to go, fourth quarter, you're trailing by 11. I wouldn't think it's too early that, you know, when you send the kid in, send him in with two or three plays. Try to get into that no-huddle offense. Try to wear this team defense down even faster of Hampden Academy.
Yeah, I think he may want to have done that, but where he's rotating so many backs and he's... Of course, now they're in the power eye left, the wing back in the backfield.
Yeah, it's Bush in there. The handoff is to Bush. Up to about the 11-yard line, maybe the 10.
Well, good job that time. But just power. Now they're just running straight power eye left and trying to run it wide off tackle and push the Hampden defense back, and they did that time. Picked up 5 yards on the play.
Hutchins came out, and Delray Meeker's in there now for Brewers. So
this has become, over the last, four or five years, a great, great rivalry, great crowds when they're either here at Hampden or over in Brewer, and this is why.
The handoff's going to be Bush, and Bush is run into some trouble there.
Well, shooting the gap was Mike Butler that time. They had a great stun on, and Butler had nothing doing. He came from his defensive tackle position, and he said, nothing doing this time, big guy. I'm meeting you in the backfield. That's what he did. Great job that time.
And now, Brewer looking at a third and six from the 13. And we'll see what Brewer decides to do here. Adams gonna keep it himself, crosses the 10.
Speaking of Ricky Adams is a senior. He's been playing football for 8 years. His nickname is Deuce. He also enjoys playing baseball and basketball, which he's an excellent shortstop for the American Legion team. His other activities are hunting and fishing. He's going to attend college, and his favorite team is the New England Patriots and the Boston Red Sox.
Brewer now looking at a fourth and two. This is the biggest play of the game for Brewer right here.
Well, this could really come down to who wins and loses this football game.
We'll see what Brewer does here. The handoff to Naughton. Naughton stood up at the line. And we'll
He's
see
very
where the
close.
Spot
we
is.
Can't see. We're going to see, depending on where the forward progress was made, is where, depending on if he gets the first down or not.
Number 64, and number 60 in there for Hampden Academy, and Brewer got the first down. Jared Kelsey of Hampden Academy, the junior, stood him at the line. 5 years of playing football, showing some experience there. And now Brewer will come back to the line with Bush in the backfield. The clock ticking away inside of about 9 minutes to go here in the fourth. The handoff is to Bush. Bush at the five, spinning in the end zone. And we have a touchdown and some flags on the play. It might be a face mask.
Yeah, we can see that up here. He was determined to get in the end zone. About the 2 yard line, he grabbed the face mask, put in. But that was an excellent run. And there's a senior right there that stepped up here, especially in the second half. Carried the ball, you know, 7 or 8 times so far, and he is well determined. He was going to get stuck on about the 3. He cut back inside and took it to the house for the 6 to bring the Witches now very close to.
Now, how is this going to work? Obviously, there was a face mask.
And probably they'll go half the distance. Always a succeeding spot. I mean, a succeeding play, which is the next play.
Now, if you're Don Farnham, the question is, do you kick the extra point or do you go for two? And it seems to be some confusion at what's going on. I think Don Farnham wants the penalty enforced on the kickoff.
Oh, they haven't put the touchdown up yet. There they go. He didn't know that they'd scored. He thought the penalty was waiting to see what was going on here.
14-9. You're down by 5. 2-point conversion brings you within 3.
And see, they're going to go for 2 because the ball's on the 1.5, like we talked about.
And Adams under center here. Now, I've been looking in the paper and watching a lot here. 2-point conversions in high school football don't seem to be too successful. And now, looks like there might be a little confusion. It's always good to see the refs talking to each other, though.
We'll wait and see. Now I think they're talking about whether the face mask was in the end zone, because if it was in the end zone when it happened, then you just go from the 3 if it was on the outside. But I can't see the ball spotted on the 3, so it was, no, is it? It's on the 1.5.
I'm thinking they're going to go Bush up the middle, or even maybe.
All right, no, they'll go Bush the fullback.
And he's in.
Great job, and that, we just said, that'll make or break the play here, maybe for the game. It'll put him within a field goal here.
So 14-11, 9:01 to go, fourth quarter. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week.
Security. You know what it means, and now you know where to find it. CBORD. If you're responsible for a school, business, healthcare facility, or any other organization, the only word you need to know when it comes to keeping your facility secure is CBORD. Because your students, customers, patients, employees, all the people who depend on you can depend on us. You just have to remember one word, CBORD.
Selection without service would be like sunshine without the warmth. Our jewelers have the experience and the tools to renew, repair, or even create jewelry with the warmth of real quality. We're Quality Jewelers. Browse in our new, larger location
in Penobscot Plaza on Washington Street in Bangor.
Welcome back to the Page Employment CBORD Security High School Game of the Week. The Brewer Witches and the Hampden Academy Broncos. It's Hampden 14, Brewer 11. Brewers making it interesting here. 3-point game now as they kick off. The kick fielded by number 26 of Hampden Academy, Ryan Lindman. And brought down at the 37 there.
Brought down by number 44, that's Dylan Betts. That's his second tackle of the night on special teams.
I want to thank some more of our sponsors, Quality Jewelers, new location at the Penobscot Plaza in Bangor for all your fine jewelry needs. Carefree Windows and Siding for your siding, window, and roofing needs. Everyone at Carefree wishes you a successful football season.
Well, if you talk about a momentum swing, even though it's, we talked about that could be a do-or-die situation for the Witches, great play calling that time by the offensive coordinator for Brewer. And you can see what a challenge the Witches now. Now they've got to really rise to the occasion. You can see the motivation change here on the sidelines.
Hand off to Ross. Ross getting a good yardage gain there. And obviously if you're Hampden, you want to take your time, run the ball, eat time off the clock. I also want to thank Bangor Optical with locations in Bangor. Check out their new office. High Center Optical, located in the Weber Building by EMMC in Bangor. And Jim's Small Engine for all your small engine repairs, along with sales and service. Smith hands off to Ross, and Ross maybe picks up two or three on the play.
Good job that time by Brewer once again gang tackling, and Anthony Noll the first one in there.
And it's third down now for Hampden, third and four, 8 minutes to go, fourth quarter. 14 to 11 your score in favor of the Broncos. Homecoming weekend, Brewer looking to be the spoiler.
And this is where the defense has really got to rise to the occasion. They got to make a stance here and put them in a fourth down situation.
Hand off to Seeger. And a big tackle by Brewer.
Great job that time by number 17, Tim Bush, one of the senior captains. And Tristan Olmix are coming in there along with number 57, Devin Fitzpatrick. So that's where we need it right there.
Bush leaving it all on the field today, offensively carrying the load in the backfield. And here he's making a big tackle here to force a fourth down. And Harry McCluskey wants to talk about it for Hampden. We're going to take a break with it. 7:22 to go, 14-11. Your score in favor of Hampden Academy. You're watching the Page Employment CBORD Security High School Game of the Week. Welcome back to the Page Employment CBORD Security High School Game of the Week. And it looks like they're going to go in, Hammond's going in a shotgun formation, fourth and one. Now look where Ross is lined up. He can't, nope, they're going, there.
Well, it's a critical stance. You don't get the ball. I mean, they stuffed him. No way, nothing doing. I mean, If I was Hampden, I would have punted the ball way down there and made Brewer go to, you know, for a drive.
Seeger tried
Holy
to jump.
Lord.
An unbelievable hit by
Anthony No comes in flying like Superman and hits him in the backfield. Nothing doing, and the Witches are going to turn it over on downs.
Unbelievable.
Well, you talk about the Witches flying high. He definitely flies high on that occasion right there. He stepped up to the plate big time for the Witches.
7:19 to go in this game. That could be the play of the game right there. Anthony No. Unbelievable.
Definitely. Instead of sticking them down maybe on the 20 or the 30 and making them go 70 or 80 yards, you know, now they're 47 yards from the score. And that's like you said, they've only need a field goal. And that last one that Fitzpatrick put in, he had it easily from 35, 40 yards.
An unbelievable hit there. Anthony No, the senior. That shows you why he's the captain as well. So Adams hands it off to Bush. The 45. Out of bounds at the 41. A good carry there by Tim Bush.
Taken out that time by Nolan Turner. I believe Nolan's a pretty young prospect for the
He's
Broncos.
A sophomore.
He's got to be a freshman or sophomore, I believe. Sophomore. Yeah, sophomore for the Broncos. So.
And the officials want a timeout. I also want to thank Bangor Tire, caring for all your automobile needs. Da Vinci Signs, when quality matters, located at the Pinewood Business Park in Herman. Dunnett's Incorporated, located at the Penobscot Plaza in Bangor. Dunnett's has done it again. Nation's Rent, for your full-service equipment resource, located on Hammond Street in Bangor, and for providing us this lift. I mean, this is unbelievable.
Yeah, we've got four guys up here, very comfortable. Got a great view of the game.
Handoff. Going to be a nod. And
nothing Hampden doing that time. Hampden defense
up.
That time. Number 53, Matt York. Met him right on the line of scrimmage.
Also, high-quality DVDs of this game will be available. Call Eric Baxter at 991-9615. Third down now, facing Brewer.
Well, they're definitely in two-down situations, so they don't need to get all set 6 or 7 yards here. It's third and six, looking at the scoreboard. So they don't need to get it all at once because they're definitely in two-down territory right here.
Also, you can purchase copies of this game at the website, myvideoproductions.com. Adams dropping back to pass. He's got Babin close to a first down.
Real close to a first down. Nice job. They've had that play very successful now, I believe, for the third time. Adams with just a quick three-step drop back, hitting Babin. Doesn't do anything special. He doesn't even block. He just goes right straight down the field, 7 or 8 yards, and looks for the ball. Adams lofts it up over the linebackers.
And the officials are going to come out and measure here. Also on that website, myvideoproductions.com, you can purchase games that were the game of the week last year of the defending state champion Brewer Witches. So Witches fans, myvideoproductions.com, you can purchase games from last year's team. There is a game with Hampden Academy on there from last year. Also, you can find some Bangor games. Also, basketball fans, there's some basketball games on there as well. So myvideoproductions.com, check it out.
Also have a very good softball game between Brewer and Bucksport over the years that it's on there. So the people listening down in the Bucksport area, of course we know that softball program as well as Brewer has been so successful throughout the years.
And as you know, My Video Productions, Page Employment, Seaboard Security, the game of the week. We're pretty much going everywhere now. And it's going to be Adams. And I believe the initial spot will give him first down.
No question in my mind. They went with a power eye formation. Power eye right, looked like they were going to just run it off tackle with a couple blockers. And Adams, a quarterback, senior, took it by himself, picked up 2 yards, and a first down for the Witches on the 35-yard line.
And now we're looking at 5:56 to go, fourth quarter. You're down by three. You're moving the ball pretty well on the ground, but you're going to have to start picking things up here. You don't want to run into a situation where you're going to have to be scrambling.
Well, checking into the game now as we see Delray Meeker. He's done a great job. 4 or 5 backs here since the second half. Actually, since about the end of the second quarter. Rotating him in, trying to wear the defensive line down for Hampden.
The handoff. Got to be to Meeker. Meeker breaks the tackle. 35. Big hit there. Woo!
Little delayed trap play by the Witches that time, but it took a little too long to develop. Meeker picks up only a yard on the play. good-looking play when it started out, but of course it collapsed so quickly that Ham did a great job of closing the gap right there and filling in the holes.
Tackle was made there by number 22 of Hampden Academy.
That would be Nolan Turner again, a sophomore for the Broncos.
And you can hear the Brewer sidelines getting into this game. 4:56 to go, fourth quarter. Their team trails by three. They hand off to Nodden. Nodden spinning and breaking some tackles. Brought down to 31. Now Doug Nodden, he's in the backfield, but previous games, you've seen him on the line.
Well, he probably sees it, probably told Coach I can run the ball. I don't know what the philosophy was, but he's doing a great job. He only picked up a couple yards, but I think Hammond's gone back to putting at least seven guys in the box and trying to clog up the run on the inside for Brewer. But Brewer's done a good job. We'll see if they may be going with a little misdirection play, which was very successful in the first half here for the Witches.
Hampden defense here is going to have to come up big. Third and six.
Once again, they're in two-down territory. Third and six.
Look at that Hampden defense. Three on the line, but you have five right up there in the front. Adams going to keep it himself. He gets up to the 30.
Did a good job that time of cutting it back to the inside. Whether he could have pitched it off, not quite sure, to Hutchins. But if he would have pitched it to Hutchins, I think Kobe may have been able to get the corner and picked up maybe enough for the first down. Now it's going to bring up a fourth and what, five? Long five here?
Now Brewer's run that play a few times now where it looks like Adams wants to pitch it, but he's hesitant on the pitch. Brewer's going to take a timeout, so we'll take the timeout with him. 3:40 to go in the fourth quarter. 14-11. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week. Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security High School Game of the Week. Adam Mahoney alongside Tim Kinney, Tom Corbett. 3:40 to go, and we mentioned earlier we had a big defensive play. This could be the biggest play of the game.
Two
right
pieces
here.
In. Jackson in right now, and number 27, Bobby Coombs.
Adam's pass is incomplete. It looks like we might have had a miscommunication there with the receiver and the quarterback, so yeah. Hampden's.
Turn the ball on downs, and we know. You probably will know who's going to get the ball this time for Hampden, 3:40. They definitely want to eat up some clock, so don't be surprised if we see Mr. Ross just eat it up. I don't know.
I'd imagine. I would imagine we're going to see, like you said, Ross carrying the ball here the whole time. We'll see what Hampden does. 3:35 to go in the fourth quarter. The Broncos are coming on the field. Brewer has, I believe, two timeouts left, so they can stop the clock. But their defense needs to come up big early here. The handoff will be to Ross. Ross crosses the 40, and it's a first down.
12 yards on the pickup.
And not what you want to have happen if you're Brewer.
Finally tackled that time by number 15, Anthony Noe. Well, Brewer's got. We've just been informed that was his 30th rush of the game. 30 rushes now for Mr. Ross.
I hope he had some pasta last night because he's going to need the carbs. Yeah.
But Brewer's got to, they got to start gang tackling. They've got to start going for the football.
And yeah, we'll see what they do here. And they're going to give it to Ross again. Crosses the 45, the 50, the 45. Brought down around the 40.
Pure determination, that's all that is. Who wants it more? And right at that time, Ross once again picks up 14 more yards.
And I don't think this year we've seen a performance from a running back like Kyle Ross has put in today. Just a phenomenal game.
No question in my mind. Great blocking, you know. He's got to have a great line, too, to get the line. He's definitely had the holes open for him today.
As we touched base earlier, the offensive line of Hampden Academy averaging 219.5 pounds. So that's a pretty big line here.
Pretty good-sized kids from high school. We can see that. There's not a lot of body fat on them, too. They're pretty physically trimmed. They've been in the weight room for the last 3 or 4 years.
Well, one of the things Kyle Ross said he enjoyed was lifting weights, so I'd imagine he gets this team in there and they lift some weights.
And unofficially, he has 30 carries for 220 yards right now.
Big day from the senior, Ross. And I'm assuming they're going to go to him again here. And up the middle is Ross.
Just a little stutter step. Third time they've done it, right up over the center. Right up the five hole, you might as well say it. Right up the gut, he just stutter step, popped over one person, picked up another 7 yards on the play.
In a game that Hampden Academy needed to win, they've shown up and they've played with a lot of...
Yeah, because of the Crabtree points and the way they were sitting. They were sitting on the outside looking in ninth. Brewer was in fifth. The loss will keep Brewer probably around 6 or 7, I'm guessing, but this will definitely move Hampden into the playoff picture now if they pull out a win here tonight with 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, it's going to be handoff to Ross again up the middle. Gets up to about the 26-yard line. And another first down, so Hampden moving the chains.
Well, that's what you got to do. That's the name of the game. When they're under 4 minutes to go, as we said, probably you'll see Ross carry the ball, which Coach McCluskey, that's all he's going to do. And keep the chains moving and that clock running here.
And it was funny talking to Coach McCluskey, like I mentioned earlier in the game, he said we want to,
thought he might have to throw the football,
yeah,
but...
go 50-50, split it up, but...
Not the way they've ran the football tonight. But you got to give Brewer credit, too, because they've hung in there.
And Smith, quarterback sneaks. And he's going to get him about a yard or two. Probably now just trying to eat up the clock here, buy some time, try to make Brewer use those two timeouts, and they're going to use one now.
Finish their timeouts here. They've got to put 8 guys on the line and try to strip.
So Brewer takes a timeout. We're going to take the timeout with them. 1:30 to go, 14-11. Your score in favor of Hampden Academy. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week. Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week. The Hampden Academy Broncos looking like they might pull this one out up to 14-11. Here's the handoff. Is given to Ross with 1:24 to go here. Fourth quarter, 14-11. Your score. Adam Mahaney alongside Tim Kinney, Tom Corbett on the stats. And Brewer, I believe, is going to use their final timeout, and they are. So Brewer really going to try to strip the ball here. I mean, you're down by three. Worst case scenario, you stop them here, but you can't stop the clock. Force Hampden to try to kick a field goal, but the way Coach McCluskey's coached this game, they're probably going to go for it on fourth down.
Probably will. When they went with fourth down and the ball in the 48 in their own territory, you know he's just going to run the football. No question. I mean, they get, you know, 2 plays to get 5 yards. Brewer's not, no more timeouts. They're knocking on the door. Ball's on the 22-yard line. And, you know, give both teams credit tonight. This has been a great. This has been a high school atmosphere that, you know, you see a lot. You go to a lot of games. They're not really supported a lot of times because one team might be winning, not. But these are two balanced teams. And I mean, look at the crowd that we've got tonight. This is, you know, this is great. A great crowd here at Hampden sponsoring and the youth of Hampden here.
Sorry. Third and five. It's probably going to be a handoff to Ross, like it is, along the far side. Brewer defenders there. And that's going to bring up fourth down in a long situation, but 1:08 to go, really.
Brewer just let the house go. They just shot. They just opened the doors and just went after them that time.
Of course, Brewer now without any timeout, so the clock is against them. The score is against them.
Yeah, Hampden may even sit down, let the clock all the way wind all the way down and take a delay of game penalty, too.
We're at 45 seconds to go here. Hampden up by three. See what they do. They're trying to.
That's what they did. Take a delay game.
Well, you figure you take the delay game. That brought the clock down to 32 seconds.
Smart move on the coach's part.
And that's only a 5-yard penalty?
Only a 5-yard penalty. So, you know, bring up a 4th and 14 here now.
Now you just run a play. Probably a run. Yeah. Don't want to try to turn it over going to the air.
Only thing is the clock's going to stop if they don't get the line to gain. Bro will get the ball over, but they'll probably only have about 20, 25 seconds to go. And not, it's not like college, a new rule will have to change the possession. The clock won't start. In college, it'll start on the ready, but in high school, it won't start until the snap.
Smith under center. Probably going to hand it off to Ross, who was right there. We have some flags. And it's a false start against Hampden. Now, this could be some, I mean.
Well, it's 5 yards, but they've just gone 10 yards the other way. So, you know, if they stop Brewer, Brewer's now only looking at, 65 yards, but it's better than 75, 80. So you kind of don't want to give him the 10 yards. Because, you know, if he put in looking ahead, he's got Bobby Coombs, which can run, and I know Tommy Jackson, that's only a sophomore, can fly, and I'm sure he'll, and Kobe Hutchins is another one that can fly down the field too, so we'll see what Coach Farnham will pull out of his sleeve here.
Looks like Hamlin's going to punt now. So there's the kick, and it's going to take a bounce, and it's going to roll. And now the clock is ticking. And that brings it down to 20 seconds. So Brewer offense coming on the field. We're going to take a break when we come back. The final 20 seconds of this one, Hampden and Brewer.
For 30 years, Bangor families have had their eyeglass prescriptions filled at Bangor Optical Center on Mount Hope Avenue in Bangor. You will always find licensed opticians on duty at Bangor Optical Center, offering a tremendous selection of styles, and with the Bangor Optical Best Price Guarantee, you will be wearing the eyeglasses you need at the best price. Quality, value, service, and style. It's Bangor Optical Center, 336 Mount Hope Avenue in Bangor.
No matter how you stack it, Page Employment has jobs.
Welcome back to the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week. A new quarterback in there at Brewer. Kobe Hutchins is in there. And he's going to keep it himself. He's going to throw, throwing deep down the field. And it's incomplete. The pass intended for number 27 of Brewer, and that is Bob Coombs.
Well, he had Coombs going across the field on a post route. Good job this time. Now he'll send in Caleb Smith, another kid that can sprint down. And you know what? He threw that ball, I think, from around the 10 or 15 all the way to midfield, and he looked like he didn't put a whole lot of effort on a 35, 40-yard pass. But Hammond just going to sit back, probably in a prevent defense with four defensive backs, play a zone coverage.
See how they line up. They've got three on the line, and they got five kind of creeping up. It's going to be Hutchins again, passing, looking, throwing down the field. Got a man intercepted by Bob Seeger. Seeger, the 30, the 25, 20. He's wanting to stay in bounds. He does. The clock's run out. Far side, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown. An unbelievable play by Bob Seeger.
Well, he did a good job. Is that they won't need to... The game's over, they won't need to do an extra point here. But a good job of staying in bounds, letting the clock run out. Brewer didn't really give up on it, but did a great job of running the opposite way into the touchdown. As we can see, the Hampden side has gone absolutely crazy.
Bob Seeger intercepts the pass, takes it to the house. 20-11, your final score. We're gonna go down to the field and wrap this one up. Hampden Academy victorious. You're watching the Page Employment Seaboard Security Game of the Week.
We'd like to thank all our employees, office staff, and of course our business clients for helping Page Employment win the Market Surveys of America's 2006 Best Employment Agency Award for the second year in a row. We're very proud of our employees and managers and the great work they do. And this year, Page Employment received a MEMC Safety Management Award for creating a safe and caring place to work. Congratulations to all from Page Employment.
During our lifetime, priorities change, and we begin to seek out products that enhance our lives. We move and we grow and come to realize what's truly important. We begin to understand the value of our time and see the results of investing wisely. Priorities change, standards don't. Paradigm Windows of Portland, Maine. Window solutions for life.
Available from Carefree Window and Siding Company. Call 989-4260.